we went over our wall weighting configuration in details here, you should understand how that's going to work. Let's move in to tuning and working with our nitrous control. There's a whole bunch of things we need to program. We need to program the arming switch. We need to program the output to control the relays, to turn on the solenoids, to turn on the nitrous and the fuel to start to spray. Now let's talk about this kit and what's distinctive about this particular kit on this car. We're using a direct port nitrous kit where we're gonna have one nitrous jet per runner, similar to the idea of a fuel injector. We're doing that so that the nitrous is going to be evenly distributed into each cylinder on the engine. Now, if you're running a fogger style nitrous kit, where you're going to have a jet or two jets on the intake pipe, that's going to be spraying into the airstream coming into the engine and has to dissipate through the intake manifold. Now, every intake manifold is going to have some flow irregularities in it, meaning one cylinder or two cylinders isn't going to get the same airflow as the others in the engine. That's just going to be inherent of an intake manifold design. Now, in that situation, if we're running a fogger setup where we're spraying the nitrous into the airstream, it's not going to distribute evenly between all the cylinders. That can be an issue because we might have one cylinder that's running lean and one cylinder that's running richer than it needs to. So by running a direct port, we can be a little bit more in control and it's going to be better and safer for the engine. Now, in addition to this, we're running a wet style kit where we're spraying additional fuel through fuel jets on the intake manifold. So we have a nitrous jet and we have a fuel jet matched to the amount of nitrous that we're spraying. So we're mechanically adding the fuel rather than doing it virtually and programming it through the actual fuel injector. It's having that fuel supplemented through that additional jet. Now, I prefer to work with wet kits compared to a dry kit. So there's the difference of a wet and a dry. A wet, we spray the fuel externally through the additional jets. The dry kit is where we just spray nitrous, but where then we're adding the additional fuel through the fuel injectors. When we're doing it in that manner, we have to go in and program the fuel delivery through the Infinity. But with the wet kit, all we need to worry about is just going in and dealing with the ignition timing, pulling out ignition timing as we spray the nitrous so that we reduce the cylinder pressure and we don't damage the engine. Spraying nitrous is going to be the same kind of idea working with a supercharger or a turbocharger. As we go up in power, as we build more cylinder pressure, we're going to find that we need to reduce the timing down because it can be definitely unsafe. We'll generate too much pressure, we get knock, we pre-ignition, the engine damage can occur. So there's things that we need to definitely take into account programming wise. Even though we're running ethanol fuel, so at this point we have our flex fuel content in the 70s right now, we should have good octane and good cooling properties from the actual ethanol. However, we still need to reduce timing. We still cannot run a ton of timing. We do have our knock control that's going to guide us in knowing if we have the proper amount of spark timing in the fuel when we're dialing in the nitrous, but we still want to make sure that we're pulling the timing out and getting everything sorted out. So this wet kit, all we're really going to be doing is dealing with our spark timing. If you're running a dry kit, you'll be tuning your fuel and your spark timing through the Infinity. So that's kind of the difference of working with one or the other. And then working between a fogger and a direct port. Direct port's always the way to go. It does take more work to set up, to bend all the lines, but you'll get a better result. You also can run a lot larger shot of nitrous with a direct port because you know it's going to distribute evenly. The larger the shot goes, from 50 to 75 to 100 to 150 to 200, the worse it will be for distributing the nitrous through the intake manifold into the cylinder. So it's very, very important if you're going to be going, my general rule is that anything over 75 shot of nitrous, go right to a direct port. Don't run a fogger on the intake pipe. That's just not going to work. 50 shot, 75 shot, you're usually good. We don't have to worry about the dissipation through the intake manifold. But when we get larger shots than that, you definitely can have damage in a cylinder if you're putting too much nitrous into a cylinder and not matching the fuel. And we have really no way to know how much more fuel we need to add when we're going in and spraying that nitrous, unless we have wide bands per cylinder, which is the ideal way to do things, but most situations that's not going to be realistic. So we're left with a single wide band measuring all of the burn and all of the cylinders, and we just want to make sure that we're getting it into each cylinder as evenly as possible. Again, the direct port has that advantage. All right, so now that we've talked about what we're working with here, let's talk about setting up the details. So with a nitrous setup here with the Infinity, we have to provide the Infinity an arming switch. It's a simple toggle switch that I have here, mounted right in front of me. This is going to allow me to tell the Infinity when I want to spray, I'm going to be turning on my arming switch that arms the Infinity so it knows that I want to start to spray nitrous. The next thing is going to be meeting virtual conditions we need to program to turn on a relay. So I have the Infinity wired in, so that it's sending an output through one of the low side outputs to a ground on our relay. So we have typical relays. In this case, I have a fuel solenoid and a nitrous solenoid. So I have two 40 amp relays and they're both triggered on with the same output, from, in this case, it's going to be LS1. We've set that up in our base map configuration way back in our, probably our very first video. If we go to wizards, let's just talk about this real quick. Setup wizard, we're going to find that in our outputs here. We have our LS1. Yep, LS1 here is set up for N2O output. So it's going to be sending the ground out, a low side out, to ground the relay, which then will then power up the solenoids. And again, I have one relay per solenoid. Very important that you don't try to pair both solenoids with one relay, because they will pull a lot of amperage, probably pull 25, 30 amps when they're on. So if we have a, let's say, a 40 amp relay feeding both of them, you're going to overdraw the relay and you're going to blow the fuses that are feeding into your relay for your fusible link. So run one fuse per relay per solenoid to avoid any issues, because again, they do draw a lot of current, and just kind of get that out of the way. So we're using our output here to be able to activate the relay, but we need to program the conditions to turn on this output. So when we designate it here to N2O output, it'll then know when we're programming our nitrous control, when we want it to turn on, to turn off, it'll know that it's tied to this output to be able to designate that functionality for the nitrous control. So that should make sense. So let's do this first. Let's close this. I'm gonna do Control G. We'll just get live here with the ECU. I'm gonna go into wizards. Let's go set up our arming switch. That's usually the very first thing we're gonna do. Go into input function assignments, and then we're gonna go here to switches. And I have my arming switch set up through digital 5. And the switch itself is going to be a ground toggled switch. So one leg of the switch goes to chassis ground. The other leg of the switch is going to go to digital 5, which is the input pin at the Infinity. We need to go and set this up so that it recognizes the roll and the actual.
Thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.